गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आर न्यू एक्सरसाइज, दैट इज़ एक्सरसाइज 6.3. सो इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फैक्टर्स. ओके, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फैक्टर्स? ना, फैक्टर इज़ अ नंबर दैट कैन डिवाइड द अनदर नंबर विदाउट लीविंग एनी रिमाइंडर. ओके, फैक्टर इज़ अ नंबर दैट कैन डिवाइड अनदर नंबर विदाउट लीविंग अ रिमाइंडर. सो इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, find the factors of the following numbers, also identify even and odd numbers. Now we have to write the factors of 16. Now 16 will come in which table, which numbers can divide 16 completely so that we cannot leave any remainder. Now it comes, we are going to start with 1. Every time you can start with 1. 1 is the factor of all number and 1 is the smallest factor of all numbers. So 1 multiplied by the 16 is equals to 16. Two factors, if you are confused that you have to write two factors, 1 and the number itself will always be factor of the factors. Okay, so suppose you have to write the factors of 16, 42, 49, 11. So 1 and the number itself will be the factor. Okay, now we are going to start with 1. 1 multiplied 16 is 16. Now does it come in the table of 2? Yes, it comes in the table of 2. 2 multiplied 8 is equals to 16. Then 4 into 3 does not have 16. 4 into 4 is equals to 16. 5 does not have 16. 6 does not have 16. 7 does not have 16. 8, we have already written 2 into 8. We have written 8 into 2 equal. Both are same, so no need to write it again. Then 8 we have written, 9 does not have 16, 10 does not have 16. We are going to leave it in that. So we have got all the 5 factors, 1, 2, 4, 16 are all the factors of 16. B part is 11. 11 is a prime number, so it will only have 2 factors, that is 1 and the number itself. Okay, so 1 and 11, the 11 does not come in any other table. So factors of 11 is 1 and 11. Now we have to write the factors of 42. So factors of 42 is 1 multiply 42 is equals to 42. When the number will end with 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. Please remember that number is an even number. So it means that it will be divisible by 2. So 42 you divide by 2, you will get 21. 2 multiply by 21, you can write 42. It means then you will not get any remainder. It means it comes in the table of 2. Please remember this thing again and again. I'm telling you this thing, that a table does not end at 10. Do not think that the table will end at 10. It will not end at 10. Okay, 2 elevens are, 2 twelves are, 2 thirteens are. So here we are getting 42 at 2 21s are. Okay, now 3 14 the. As you can see, now we will check with 3 table. 42 is there, na? When you will learn, now next exercise will be divisibility rule. When you are going to learn the divisibility rule, beta, it will be very easy for you to find out whether this number is divisible by 2, whether this number is divisible by 3. But before that, when you don't have any idea about divisibility rule, you have to divide it and then you have to check it. So divide 42 by 3. So when you will divide 42 by 3, you will get 14 as your quotient and remainder will be 0. So when your remainder is 0, it means that it is divisible. So you are going to write 3 multiply 42 is 14 is equals to 42. Now next will be 4. 4 does not have 42. 5 does not have 42. 6 has 42. 6 multiply 7 is equals to 42. Again, we are not going to write about 7, 6, 8 does not have 42, 9 does not have 42, 10 does not have 11, 12, 13, no. 14, 3, the 21, 2, and 42, 1. That's the only factors that we have for 42. Okay, factors of 42, then again you are going to write 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 14, 21, 42. All these are the factors. You can write like this also. 42 ones are, 21 twos are, 14 three the, 7 six the. Then it will become all the factors. Okay, then come on 49. 49 comes in one table, 1 multiply 49 is equals to 49, 7 into 7. You check any other number, 49 does not come in any other number. So we have here 49 factors are 1, 7 and 49. 1, 7 and 49 are the factor, only 3 factors are there. Then the question is that we have to find out the even and odd numbers also. Even numbers are those number which come in the table of 2. So all this number, these all are having the factors 2, as you can see, 2, 2. those who are not having the factors of 2, they will come in the odd number. The numbers that does not come in the table of 2 will be the odd number. So all this number come in the table of 2. So these are the even number. It will be divisible by 2 and with remainder 0. And this the numbers that does not come in the table of 2 are called odd numbers. Please remember this thing. Even number will always end with the term 6, 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. Even number will always end with these terms. Okay, ones place we will always have 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. Please remember. Okay, now let us come to question number 2 that we have done in the class, that you have to do in the book. Write true or false for each of these statement. 3 is a factor of 20. Here 3 is a factor of 20, it is written. Does 3 table have 20? No, 3 table does not have 20. So we are going to write false here. Okay. Now, 1 is the greatest factor of any number. Is it greatest factor? Like, we do not have any other bigger factor than this. This is wrong. 1 is the factor of every number, any number, but it is not the greatest one. It is the smallest one. So, that's why we are going to write false here. 5 is the factor of every odd number. Is it true that every factor, every odd number will have 5 as a factor? Now, we have find out here 2 odd numbers, that is 11 and 49, and both are not having 5 as factor. So, it is false. It is not possible that every odd number will have 5 as factor. Now, 18 is a factor of 9. 18 is a factor of 9. It is given opposite here. Here, this something like opposite is given. If it is written 9 is the factor of 18, it must be true. But 18 is not the factor of 9 because 18 does not, 9 does not come in the table. 18 is a factor of 9. Okay. Now, 18 does not come in the table of, 9. 18 will not divide 9. Okay, 18 will not divide 9. That's what you have to remember. 18 is bigger number and 9 is smaller number. Every number is a factor of itself. That is true. Because as you can see that we have done so many questions. 16, 11, 49. Here we have done 42. All the numbers were having the factor, the number itself. So that's why it is true. Now the question number 3. Fill in the blanks for multiplication statement. 17 multiply 3 is equals to 51. So we have to use this. These two are both the factors and this one we are getting the product. Okay. So it means that 51 will come in the table of 3 also. 51 will come in the table of 17 also. Now he says 17 is a dash of 51. So obviously 17 is the factor of 51. 71 will divide this 51. It will not be the multiple. Multiple will always be bigger than the number. Equal or bigger than the number. Whereas factor will be smaller than number. Please remember this thing. 51 is a multiple of 17. Yes, that's true. Because 17 you multiply by what number? 17 you multiply by 3, I guess. Then you are going to get what? You are going to get 51, right? So, when you are going to multiply 17 once a 17, 17 to the what? 34, right? Then 17 3 the what you are getting? You are getting 51. Okay, so 51 is the multiple of 17. Now, 3 is dash of 51. 3 is the factor of 51 because 3 in 3 table 51 comes. And 51 is the multiple of 3. Yes, 51 is the multiple of 3. You are going to multiply, you are going to divide 51 by 3. So, what you are getting? You are getting what? You are getting 27, right? 27, we are having this. 17 is having this. 17 3 is a 21. So, that's why we are going to say it is a multiple. Okay. Now, come on question number 4. A group of 16 dancers need to stand in a row in such a way that all rows have the same number of dancers. Like every row should have same number of dancers. They have to make an arrangement like that. Arrangement you have to make so that we can, in how many ways, different ways that we can divide the groups. Now, in rows we have to make the dancers stand. So, how can we arrange the dancers so that equal number of people will be standing in each row. Okay, so how we are going to arrange? So for that we are going to find out the factor. Factor of 16 is 1 into 16, 16. So we will not be taking this one because obviously we cannot make 16 groups 1, 1, 1. So it is not an arrangement. So we are going to start from here. 16 comes in the table of 2, add 8, 16. 4 into 4 is also 16. So the different arrangement for the dancers are that can be 8 rows and 2 dancer each, 8 rows, 8 रोज में 2 2 डांसर और 2 रोज 8 डांसर ईच, 2 रोज 8 डांसर ईच अपोजिट ऑफ दिस बिकॉज 2 इंटू 8 इज ऑल्सो 16 एंड 8 2 इज ऑल्सो 16. देन 4 रोज विद 4 डांसर ऑल्सो वी कैन मेक द अरेंजमेंट. ओके लाइक दिस यू कैन मेक द स्टेटमेंट. यू सिंपली हैव टू फाइंड आउट द फैक्टर ऑफ ऑल दीज नंबर्स एंड देन यू हैव टू डू द अरेंजमेंट्स. नाउ 72 कैंडीज नीड टू पैक देन बॉक्सेज इन सच अ वे दैट एवरी बॉक्स हैज एन इक्वल नंबर ऑफ कैंडीज. So there are 72 candies and you have to pack in equal number of boxes. You have to pack in equal number of boxes. So what are the different possible ways? Same type of question that you can pack in the candies, how you are going to pack the candies. So again, you have to find out the 72 factors and then you have to make the arrangements like this. Okay, like this you have to make the arrangements. 18 chocolates need to be packed in such a way that each packet has an equal number of chocolates should have. You should have equal number of chocolate in each packet. What are the different combination in which the chocolates can be packed? So different combination in which, again you have to find the different combination. So you have to find the 80's factors. Okay, all the factors of 80 you have to find out and then you have to write that using the help of fourth. Okay, this one here you have to just simply find out the factors of all these number. I've given this homework. I've given D, F, G homework. And this question number 5 and 6 is also homework. I hope that these questions will be clear to you, everyone. Okay, bye-bye. Have a good day.